Too busy golfing earlier to grab a bite to eat? No problem. More dining opportunities await.
That is certainly true. Route 53 has food in great quantity, but it's the quality that's special.
It is not easy to find a parking space at Previte's Marketplace in Weymouth.
We have customers that frequent our stores every day. They come in for the special cuts of meat, for their tailgate parties, holiday roast.
Joe Previte is the second generation owner of his family business.
Previte's originated by my mother and father. They started in 1963 in Quincy, small little corner variety store. As the years went on, we got into the meat business. I'm a second generation. My son actually just came on board, Joe the third, and then a lot of my employees have longevity with us. We have one in particular employee who's been with us for 45 years.
Locals and professionals come from all over for meats, salads, and specialty items. But at lunchtime, everyone's coming for a sandwich.
I work right down the road, so we come here for lunches, sandwiches for the girls. Oh, I love the small town butcher shop type feel, but I love their food. They're great.
Meats are processed downstairs to be shipped out or sold at the store.
Freshest meat you can buy. We have some marinated steak tips, marinated chicken items, and then also we do a lot of prepared foods that people can come in, take something home for a quick dinner.
And make sure to save room for dessert.
It's a great marriage having Fratelli's with us. They're an outstanding bakery. Customers like the convenience of coming into our store and picking up a party platter or a special roast for the holidays, and then they can go right next door for Fratelli's and get some delicious fresh baked products that go along with their parties.
With a new store coming soon on Route 53 in Hanover, Joe says he'll maintain the quality and service his customers expect.
People like what we stand for. They like our service, our quality, and I think that's why they end up coming back for that traditional type items.
Still hungry? In Duxbury, you'll find a Route 53 staple, Bongi's Turkey Roost.
Bongi started in 1938. My grandparents moved here. They purchased 7 acres for $400. Friday afternoons, when this was the main road to the Cape, traffic would be stopped here. It would be like a complete traffic jam. My mother and her brother, they used to go out to the cars that were parked out and on the road, and they used to service them. They used to go right from the store right out there, and then provide them with box lunches.
Even now, travelers continue with their Bongi's tradition.
We still get a lot of people coming to and from the Cape. They know where we are. Obviously, they have to get off and come see us now because this is no longer the main road to the Cape. But we still get a lot of people that summer in the Cape, and on their way back through, they'll stop here and they'll grab a bunch of frozen pies for their freezer.
Bongi's is a year-round business, selling all the fixings for a turkey dinner.
In the fall, you know, with Thanksgiving, we do a lot of cooked turkeys, and we do fresh turkeys for the holidays. And then after Christmas, we really turn into a turkey pie factory. We make turkey pies every day. We have got 15 different varieties and sizes of turkey pies, and that keeps us busy right through the spring.
And summer calls for more than just turkey sandwiches.
Probably the biggest thing that we do in the summertime is fried chicken and sell that for backyard picnics or people going to the beach. A lot of the people that come in today have been coming here for 50, 60 years. They share stories of when they used to come as kids, and now they're coming in with their kids. So it's really neat to see multiple generations coming in and still visiting us here.
And Tom Pierce of Bongi says that his grandparents started with a chicken farm.
Chicken farm, yeah. And as more and more chicken farms came along, they switched to a turkey farm. So you ask, why so many farms? Well, it was before refrigerated trucks, so people would buy their poultry directly from the farm. And actually, Bongi's ended up being part of an area known as Turkey Row. There were a whole bunch of turkey farms there. They are the last one standing.
Wow. Mm-hmm. There you go. Well, we measure job satisfaction in Hanover in a moment.
If you put her against another 22-year-old who is out in the workforce, I'll bet she's having a lot more fun.